Hi, welcome to Superboot. It's been a while. It's great to be back. And I'm Joran from Your Analog. This is Fritz. And as always, we have some new stuff, new Eurorack. So I'm going to give you a really quick overview of the new things. That's Step 8, Orbit 3, and Enhance 2. And right now we have Orbit 3 and Enhance 2 making some interesting sounds, making some interesting visuals. Let's get started with Orbit 3. That's a Chaos oscillator. And the Chaos is an interesting thing. It's not quite random. It's not quite regular. It gives you a lot of control. You can really change things. Let's remove some things and make some chaotic sounds. So what we've got here is a special kind of oscillator, and you can think of it as two particles, or one particle rather, floating around two equilibrium points in a three-dimensional space. So we've got, you can see it on the oscilloscope as well, and I can change it about a bit. You can move any of those points. Can change the size of the orbits using distribution control. You can change the frequency, and it'll go really slow as well. And it has these interesting stable points. Next to that we have Enhance 2, and I'm using that for some stereo-ness. And Enhance 2 is a stereophonic enhancer, so it gives you balance control, left and right. We also have a width control for mono to stereo. And we go from stereo to mid-side, so we have a mid-side processing with tilt filters. And Enhance 2 is a very useful tool if you're doing anything with stereo in Eurorack, because you get this voltage control, balance control, you get stereo width control, you get tilt filters for your mid and side, so you get this spectral control aspect to your stereo image. And of course, mid-side processing within the rack, and back to stereo out. And there's also step 8, and that's a big one. And to demonstrate that, I'll have to patch a little bit more. Ooh. Right. So step 8 is all about taking the concept of sequential synthesis and taking it to the next level. So we have a 1-to-8 sequential switch feeding into 8 track and hold stages. And at first glance, it looks a bit like a basic step sequencer. But if I enable the hold, the all switch rather, we see the hold action on all of the outputs. So now every time the register goes to the next stage, it holds the last voltage on the previous one. And of course you have these attenuation sliders, so it can turn things all the way up. And I'll just off on it soon. So that's just the basic cycle mode. There's also a shift register mode, and now it becomes an 8-stage sequential, or rather an 8-stage analog shift register. So on every step, it'll take a sample. Next step, it'll move the sample, the analog stored voltage, to the one next to it. There's also a solo all switch, and that just mutes the inactive stages, so it becomes more like a standard sequential switch. And you get tracking or sampling, so it can either constantly track the input, or it can just take a sample and it'll take a very short sample and use that as the analog data. And for control, we have our step input, step output, pause, reset, reverse, and you can even use an analog voltage to address the register. And application-wise, yeah, it's pretty wild. Actually, all of them are pretty wild. So it's a very short space of time to try to explain all of them. But I hope this gave you a really quick overview of them. And if you're interested, there's still some time to come by the booth, and otherwise there's all sorts of YouTube stuff, or just send me an email, and let's talk about the new modules more in detail. So that was my part, and I'm going to hand things over to my colleague Fritz, who is going to give you a much more musical thing, much more musical aspects to the whole Eurorack thing than I could ever manage. So I hope you'll enjoy this little performance, and thanks for your attention. Thank you.
I'm